Testing, testing. Can everybody hear me?
Yes.
Cool. All right. Thank y'all for coming out. I'm sorry in advance if that keeps happening. I'll do my best not to move around. I want to get us started with some chants. You might have heard this one before. From the river to the sea,
Palestine will be free.
From the river to the sea,
Palestine will be free.
From the river to the sea,
Palestine will be free.
Free, free Palestine.
Free, free Palestine.
Viva, viva Palestina.
Viva, viva Palestina.
I'm just figuring out the best way to hold this. all right. On this day, 1 year ago, the Palestinian people bravely launched a coordinated effort against the Zionist state of Israel, which has been violently occupying Palestine for decades. We must remember that the genocide of the Palestinian people did not begin on October 7th, and the resistance to that genocide, the armed resistance, did not begin on October 7th. The people of Palestine have been fighting for almost 100 years against mass displacements, imprisonment, and massacres. They have every right to fight back. They have every right to rebel. As of April of this year, advocacy groups estimated that there are over 9,000 Palestinians in Israeli prisons. The real number is likely much higher. One in every five Palestinians has been arrested and charged by Israeli forces at some point in their lives. Every single one of these Palestinian prisoners are political prisoners. They are taken from their homes and neighborhoods for the crime of being Palestinian, for the crime of resisting the brutal occupation of their land. Over 3,000 Palestinians in Israeli prisons are being held without charge. We will often hear people say that Israel is in violation of international laws, that the UN and the International Criminal Court should hold them accountable. But these are the same international laws that allow Israel to try Palestinians in military courts instead of civil ones. Oh, sorry, I lost my voice. This is a right afforded to Israel as the occupying force in Palestine. We cannot rely on the laws of bloodthirsty imperialists to end the occupation and the suffering of the Palestinian people. We must make a clear and resounding call for the victory of the Palestinian resistance and the fall of Zionism. Israel has billions of dollars of military aid at its disposal. It has the backing of the most powerful imperialist nations in the world, primarily the U.S. And yet, they have been met with the steadfast and unwavering fighters of Palestine, and they have struggled and faltered in their goals. The armed resistance of the Palestinian masses is what has prevented the complete and total destruction of Gaza. It has inspired and galvanized the masses of people worldwide living under the boot of imperialism. And it will be what leads to a free Palestine in our lifetimes. The US and its allies will continue to spin their web of lies, telling us that what we are seeing unfold before us is a war between a civilized country and a group of terrorists. They will try to tell us that the situation is too complex to understand, that we must try to reach a two-state solution, that the Palestinians must accept their own occupation and suffering. And that is all these talking points are, lies. Lies that serve the interests of the okay. I'll wait. Lies that serve the interests of the shared enemy of working people, the ruling class. The ruling class that would see an entire people wiped off the face of the earth if it meant they would see a return on their investments. The ruling class that would take our tax dollars and send them to Israel in the form of weapons and fighter jets that are used to kill children in their beds. And there is a reason the ruling class is afraid of demonstrations like this. There's a reason they're afraid of the popular support for the Palestinian people and their ongoing resistance. They know that the struggle for a free Palestine is one part of a larger international struggle for revolution. It has been an entire year of protests, marches, direct actions, teach-ins, and meetings. The genocide continues. The U.S. continues to send billions of dollars in military aid to Israel, even as they expand their campaign of terror into Lebanon and Syria. We have presidential candidates who have expressed nothing but unwavering support for Israel and its right to defend itself. We have just seen one of the deadliest natural disasters in U.S. history devastate Florida and North Carolina, where millions of people are without electricity, food, and water, and the police are guarding grocery stores there. We live in the wealthiest nation on earth, but the majority of working people have little to no reliable health care, struggle to buy groceries, and work multiple jobs just to get by. I don't say all of this to discourage us. I don't say this to dampen our spirits. I say this because it is the reality, and it should make us furious. It should disgust us, because that is the reality of capitalism. It will always, always put profit over human lives. It will put profit above all else. It cannot be reformed and it cannot be fixed because it is not broken. It is working exactly as intended. And it is because of this that we must strengthen our resolve. We must understand the path that lies ahead of us. We refuse to accept this rotten world and we will fight for a better one. Today we are gathered to honor this last year of Palestinian resistance, as well as all the years that came before. And we are also here to support the years of resistance to come, the continued struggle against imperialism worldwide. Yeah. And we are here to say to the politicians and the pigs and the ruling class, we know what you stand for, we know what you protect, we know what you are, and we will not do as we are told. We will not vote in your sham election.